que respondeu bem, né? Today we have come together to witness the joining of these two lives. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They met each other, fell in love, and are finalizing it today on their wedding day. Romance is fun, but true love is something far more, and is their desire to love each other for life that is what we are celebrating here today. In marriage, it is the little things, and there are big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is standing together and facing the world. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. And it is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is not only marrying the right person, but it is being the right partner. Ray and Donna have prepared their own vows.
You have changed my beliefs and brought me to a place where I thought I would not get to again. You have been the exception to every rule that I have made myself. You have been my anchor. You renewed my trust and you walked through me through dark times without ever leaving my side. You loved my daughter, our daughter, more than I thought any person knew. The miracle of our love lies in the path that we now walk together as a family. So I commit to you my love, my devotion, my loyalty, and I promise to you that you will never walk the path alone again.
Ray, from the moment we met, you surprised me, captivated me, and challenged me in every way I thought no human could ever do before. I vow to always be your shotgun rider, sing out of tune duets. I vow to always stand by your side to support you, frustrate you, and challenge you. I vow to spend the rest of my life beside you, laughing with you, crying with you, laughing at you, smiling, and growing together. You are my 42.
Donna has
additional
vows to Lydia. Ray and Donna, I would ask that you always treat yourself and each other with respect. Ray told me I'm forbidden from putting anything resembling Corinthians in here, so I'm going to take something from my favorite book, Matthew. We must be reminded that what God has united, man must not separate. Ray and Donna, give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do every relationship at one point or another, focus on what still seems right between you, not only the part that seems wrong. Ray, do you take Donna to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her?
I do.
Forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore?
I do.
Donna, do you take Ray to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding unto him forevermore? The ring is a symbol of an unbroken circle of love. Love freely. Given has no beginning and no end, No giver and receiver for each is the giver, and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you the vows you have taken. I, Red.
I, Red.
Take thee, Donna.
Take thee, Donna.
To be my wife.
Be my wife.
To have and to hold. In sickness and in health. For richer or for poorer.
For richer.
In joy and sorrow. And I promise my love to you. And with this ring, I take you as my wife for as long as we both shall live. To make your relationship work will take love. This is the core of your marriage and why you are here today. It will take trust to know that in your hearts you truly want what is best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn to grow together. It will take faith to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings. And it will take commitment to hold true the journey you both have pledged together. By the power that's in me, I now pronounce you man and wife. You make this your bride.